On today's video, what we're going to talk about is how to add dark mode to a website. So what we have on screen is something that looks like this. And if I go into my system settings and just change to dark mode, what we'll get is a brand new color scheme that looks like this. So what we can do very easily using a little bit of CSS is switch between one mode to another. So firstly, let's have a look at the code behind this website. It's fairly simple. So we've got some simple HTML, kind of the usual stuff. We've got a header and a section in here and some other things we'll talk about a little bit later. And then a style sheet that's fairly simple as well. We have our usual stuff with some colors that look like this, and our links are down here as well. Now, the first thing we need to think about is if we change the color scheme right now, what does it look like? Well, it stays the same on dark and light mode, which kind of makes sense because what we have in our colors right now is the background is always this red and the text color is always this black. Now, what we need to do is make these changeable. So how do we go about doing this? Well, what I like to do is make these CSS variables. Now, what is a CSS variable? Well, it means it's something I can change and hold. You know, if the weather's variable, it's something that changes. Here, we are changing our colors. So what we're gonna do is set that up. I'm gonna do this towards the top here, just because I wanna do it at the top and then use it for the rest. And the way we do CSS variables is like this. We do colon and then root and then some curly brackets. And then basically we can give some variable names. Here, I'm gonna call this one dash dash. All of them always start with dash dash and then background underscore color, just to set up the variable. And my default background color is this color here. So let's take this. I'm gonna copy this and paste it here. And we missed a hash out at the start and let's close it off. Now let's do this for a like text color as well. So let's have a dash dash text color. And this one, it's gonna be this black color here. So I'm gonna take that and paste it there. Again, I've missed my hash out. So let's add that in. Now, at the moment, we're not using these CSS variables in here. So to change that, all I'm gonna do is just get rid of this and replace it for a var. And in round brackets, the name of the variable here, we're gonna have the dash dash background color. If this was called primary color, this would be called primary color as well. And what do we want for the color here? Again, it's a var, and then the text color. And again, if we save this right now and we go and refresh, nothing's changed. All we've done is we've said that the color of the page is now held as a variable. But what we want to do is basically change this on our mode, our kind of dark mode, our appearance. How do we do this? Well, if we think about things like media queries where we are changing the size of the page for responsive layouts, basically this is changing the layout. Here, what we want to do is change it based on the appearance. So again, we're going to use a media query, but not listen to the width. We're going to listen to the appearance of the page itself. So to do this, I'm actually going to do that near my CSS variables to kind of keep them together. What we're going to do is at media, and in brackets, we're going to use prefers color dash scheme colon dark. And with curly brackets, we're going to say, well, when it's dark mode, what do we want to do? Well, here what I want to do is switch these variables around or change the colors. So I'm going to do the same thing, root, and then curly brackets in here, and I'm going to change the background color and the text color. So dash dash background color, because I want to overwrite it with this black background. So let's use that, and we'll put a hash at the start. And we want to make the text color red instead. So dash dash text color, and this is going to be this red color. So let's get it from here. And we'll paste that in there. And let's see if this works. So now if we save it and we go back to our site, currently I'm in light mode. If I go to dark mode, what we should get is our color changes. Now, if we want to change these link colors, what we need to do is set up a new color for white and then maybe change it to what we want. But what we have on this page as well is if I just move this over here, I have these kind of form elements, which are not really styled. And if I see this going from light to dark, these don't really change as well. So how would we do this? Well, let's quickly have a look. So in my style sheet, all I've got in here is some styles, just default ones for the text area and button for that form. They're not really doing anything in here. I could set some backgrounds on here to kind of style them up, but maybe I want to use the default kind of Mac OS or OS style on this. How do we do this? Well, what I want to do is just basically tell everything in my HTML that if I'm preferring a dark mode, everything should be in dark mode. So to do this, we're going to add a little bit extra to our media query here. HTML and in curly brackets, we want the color dash scheme to be in dark. So if we're saying our operating system prefers dark, our HTML should prefer dark as well. So let's save this and let's see if this works. So back on my page, I'm going to refresh and my text area is now in the dark mode. So I can easily switch between this and notice these are just defaults in here using the kind of color scheme that we have on our system. So it's very easy to add a quick dark mode into this and we can add it in with just a few lines of CSS. If you like this video, please give it a like and subscribe. And of course, we have many courses over at cpy.com. And if you have any requests for tutorials, please put them in the comments below.